Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. We anticipated some stronger seismic activity around the 11th due to some critical planetary geometry, not really too critical. And we can actually see 5.6 right on the 11th, which means that there wasn't too much critical stress in Earth's crust. We also see a huge clustering of moderate to strong seismic activity, around 5.7, and that happened on the 9th, 10th. At the time of this critical planetary geometry, this was a red peak, like I said, not too critical. And we also see some critical geometry involving Venus. These are the purple peaks on the 7th and also on the 8th. And usually we see this clustering of stronger earthquakes. Stronger earthquakes rarely occur on average. Usually they cluster, and this is just another example of this clustering coinciding with some critical planetary geometry. So what are we going to have in the next few days? I already briefly mentioned the critical geometry, a clustering of planetary geometry around the 13th, that's today. And we can actually see that here on the SSGI graph, a red peak and also two 90 degree angles also involving Mercury. Mercury is really at the center at this time. And if we look at the solar system real quick, we can see the red lines, the Mercury-Sun-Saturn conjunction that happened early this morning. And we also see two 90 degree angles involving Mercury. One is with Mercury, Earth and Mars. And that actually happened yesterday night. And we also see, that will be later today, another 90 degree angle that is also with Mercury and Venus and Jupiter that will be around 1800 hours today. So we have two 90 degree angles converging with a planetary conjunction, Mercury, Sun, Saturn. And this could really result in some stronger seismic activity. I could say borderline 6, but it could well reach mid to higher 6 magnitude. If we go back to the SSGI graph, we can see the lunar peaks later tomorrow on the 14th and also one on the 16th. Now, I actually anticipate larger seismic activity to occur on the 14th, 15th, following this planetary convergence, the convergence of planetary geometry today. So 14th, 15th, most likely, there is a slight possibility that we will have this stronger seismic event, possibly higher 6 magnitude on the 16th at that second lunar peak. But in my current estimate, I think that the largest seismic activity is likely to occur on the 14th, 15th. It could be a swarm or a clustering of stronger seismic events approaching magnitude 6, but I really think that it will go over magnitude 6 this time. We could have one or two low 6 magnitude earthquakes. We could have a single larger seismic event, like I said, potentially mid to high 6 magnitude 14th, 15th. And if it arrives late, it will be on the 16th. But the convergence of critical geometry, if we go back to the solar system real quick, that is serious, a serious convergence. And especially because Mercury is at the crosshairs this time, there can be some serious seismic activity. I don't think it will reach magnitude 7. I really think it will stay about mid to high 6 in a worst case scenario. If we look at the atmospheric fluctuations that we had in the last couple of days, again, I show you the fluctuation on 8 April that was at the Nicobar Islands and also to the north near the Assam region, Tibet. Then on the 10th, we had some atmospheric fluctuations over the West Pacific, and that was really to the north of Japan and also close to Taiwan and Sumatra, and to the east around the New Britain region. We had fluctuations also on the 11th, and it was again near Guerrero, Mexico, the Gulf of Mexico. Seismic activity could occur a bit to the north or to the south. This is a rough estimate, but we have seen several fluctuations over that area, so there could be upcoming larger seismic activity there in the near future. And then again also to the south, west of New Zealand. Not sure if that is really significant, but I sure think that the fluctuation near Guerrero, Mexico, could be to the north, to the south. That is a serious one, and it could also become relevant in the next few days. This is the seismic update for today. Stay safe. Until next time.